So let's talk about web browsing. When you browse the web, your primary tool is this text field here. Sometimes it's called the address field, the address bar, search box, all sorts of different things. There's just this one field here to type something in the top, and what you type starts you off looking at things on the web. Now there are two very different kinds of things you can type in here. One is a search term, and another is an actual location on the web, an address, sometimes called a URL, Universal Resource Locator. So, for instance, if you wanted to search for something, you would type a series of words. And then you hit return, and notice it tells you right here that it's going to search Google. And you get a page of search results. Let's close the sidebar there, and you can see your search results. You haven't actually gone anywhere yet. All you've done is gone to a page on Google, which has given you search results, and from here you can click on one of those to go to a web page. Now, alternatively, the second thing that you could do with this is enter a web address. So, you could enter an address like macmost.com. Now, there's a big difference here between typing just macmost and macmost.com. Notice when I type macmost, it still says search Google. I haven't typed a valid web address. All valid web addresses start with a domain name like macmost.com. It's got to be .com, .org, .edu, .gov, .net, and there's a ton of other ones, .tv, etc. But it's got to be .something. It's got to be the actual address of the web page. So notice if I just type macmost and I don't have a period anywhere followed by something like .co or .com, it's going to assume I want to search. So this is a problem a lot of people have. They'll actually say, well, I want to go to this website called macmost, and they search Google for it instead of just going directly there. If you type macmost.com, it actually goes to macmost.com. And this goes for any website on the internet. Now, in addition to going to a domain name like macmost.com, which will take you to the front page of any website, you can go directly to a page. So for instance, if I were to click here and go to this page and look here at the top, I see a complete URL, which is macmost.com/ and then the page location that usually ends with the .html or .htm. It doesn't really have to be anything specific, but it does have to be something after a slash. Now, you probably don't know the location of most web pages, but if you did, you could actually type them. So for instance, I could go somewhere else, like let me just clear this page, and if I went in here and I typed or pasted that full address to that page, I could go directly to that page. Now, one of the things that further confuses people is they don't see this entire address up here. You can see it when I do it, and the reason for that is if I go to Safari Preferences under Advanced, I have checked Show Full Website Address. If I turn that off, you can see it's going to show you macmost.com no matter where I am inside that site. So turn that on so you can see clearly where you're at. But the most important takeaway from this is that if you're going to go to a website, when you start typing the name, sometimes you get a little hint where it gives you the .com afterwards, but sometimes you don't. Like that. In that case, you have to put on the .com yourself. Otherwise, you're going to go to a search result and not the actual website, and it's going to take a whole additional step. And it may take a little extra time for this page to load. You may actually get other results at the top that aren't what you want. So you definitely want to keep in mind that when you're typing an address, type the whole thing.